In this tutorial, I will explain the operation of the camera-based positioning sensor of the IPS 200i or 400i series, as well as the quick start via the guided wizard. The IPS is used for the rack fine positioning of a stacker crane. The sensor detects round markings in the form of a hole or reflector in the bar and determines the position deviation between the center of the marking and the sensor on the stacker crane. To open the web-based configuration tool webConfig, you need an internet browser on your PC and an Ethernet connection to the sensor. We can recommend a current version of Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox. When connecting, it is important that the IP address range of your PC is in the same address range as the sensor. By default, the sensor has the IP address 192.168.60.101 and is entered up here in the address line of your browser. The webconfig subsequently opens in process mode. In process mode, the sensor reacts to the signals from its controller and the digital switching inputs. Here you can see a current image, the status value, the position values in X and Y, the quality value of the current positioning. Next to it, you can see the history of the last positionings. Important in this context is the status value. Value 0 shows that a positioning was successful. Unsuccessful positionings are shown with value 1 and 2. Value 1 shows if several holes with the same diameter were detected. Value 2 shows if no hole was found. This status value can also be output via the interface. When changing to service, disconnect the sensor from the host interface. In the IPS, you have the possibility to save up to 8 programs, i.e. different configurations. You can use different programs, for example, for positioning on holes or reflectors, or for a defined offset value in the sensor for loading and unloading positions. You can select the current valid program via the project management, and it is displayed in the header. The switching of the programs in the process mode can be done either via two digital switch inputs or via the host interface, e.g. in Profinet via module 6.1. Back on the selection page, you have the possibility to start the wizard, which we will do in a moment, or to edit the current project, i.e. program, directly, to reload a file already stored on your PC into the sensor, save the complete configuration of the sensor to your PC. When importing files again, it is important that the configuration file contains the application parameters as well as the communication settings, i.e. IP address, and for Profinet also the station name. Now we start the wizard. The wizard guides you quickly through the essential settings of the sensor. The optimization then takes place via the detail pages in the respective program. First, select the current program you want to configure. We take program 1 and press Next. You can edit the tabs with the button Continue/Back or quit at any time with Cancel. A help function explains the current step. The Picture tab is about the sufficiently bright contrast of the marker. It is important to get a good, even contrast from the bolt to the hole. Make sure that the sensor is aligned so that the hole is in the center of the image and there are no disturbing reflections behind the hole. Adjust the sensor if this is not the case. In combination with reflectors, we recommend setting a very short exposure time as the reflectors have been optimized for this purpose. The exposure time is automatically taught in via the teach button. This can also be set manually using the slider. If the exposure time is too high, the whole loses contrast and size. Each time a parameter is changed, a new image is also captured. You can also capture a new image using the camera button here in the upper left corner. The checkbox Exposure Time Dynamics affects the control of the sensor in the process mode in the reading gate control mode. With Exposure Time Dynamics, the contrast in the center is checked during a reading gate after each image acquisition and readjusted if necessary. Now we have a sufficiently good contrast. Now we switch to the next tab marker. In the wizard, the sensor automatically determines the marker hole as dark and the reflector as light. The valid marker is marked in green in the image. The working area slash catch area is the blue frame. This cannot be changed in the wizard, but it can be changed in the detail view. If possible, the sensor moves the coordinate system to the center of the hole. The determined position deviation is the distance of the hole center to the coordinate origin of the working area in X and Y. Important is the real distance between the sensor and the hole. Please enter it here. In my case, it is 300 millimeters. Then the sensor automatically calculates the hole diameter. This can vary depending on the distance. You can then enter an offset for X or Y. This directly influences the output position value. Finally, we have the tolerance in X and Y. This parameter only has an influence if you position over the four digital switching outputs. If you are using the position value in millimeters via the control, this parameter is not important. If you position over the switching outputs of the sensor, this tolerance value in X and Y forms a rectangle around the coordinate origin of the working area. If the center of the marker is then in the tolerance range, the corresponding square switches. The quality value is 100% and thus shows that the detection is very good. Now we switch to the next tab, operating modes. Here we are talking about the sequence of image acquisition and the output of the position values during process operation. Let's start with the reading gate control. The reading gate control can be activated using a digital input, an online command, or, in the case of Profinet, via module 10. As long as the reading gate is activated, the sensor continuously takes images and determines position values, which it then outputs to the interface. You must deactivate the reading gate again. In the detailed view, you have the possibility to select a sequential reading gate control. This differs in another temporal measured value output on the interface. In the single trigger mode, only one image is captured after activation, and one position value is output. The next tab is output. In our example, for a sensor with Ethernet interface, you have to activate the output via the Ethernet interface, then set whether they communicate via TCP/IP or UDP. Here I use TCP/IP and the mode server. The left side shows the sensor and the right side the host. At the sensor side, you see the set IP address of the sensor and the port number. This is set to 10,000 by default and we leave it like this. Now we're done with the wizard for the first program, and the last point is the summary of the set parameters that you can print by clicking the button. Now click to the Finish button to end the wizard. Afterwards, you can configure further programs with the wizard or switch from the service mode to the process mode by clicking the button in the upper left corner. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. Here we offer further videos on commissioning support. If you have any questions, please contact our technical hotline or your Lloyd's sales representative. You can also visit our website at lloydse.com.